poverty made people fighters. It was poverty that made fighters of men. Some was only prepared to fight for a dinner, to provide for their parents and their brothers and sisters.
I think Bermondsey has won more Lonsdale belts than any other district.
A youngster leaves school today, starts work with 10 or 12 quid a week. What do we want to know? Poverty created fighters. When you are hungry, you might have no idea, might be a peaceful, docile sort of person. But the mere fact that you could earn half a quid or a pound by having a fight, oh, that was it.
So I says to him, if I get beat the first series, how much do I get? He said, you get 10 shillings, or does it say? It takes a big so we go home. Anyhow, the night of competition, I had three fights the first night. And I came home to my wife's in bed with my kid. So she said, may I have to get on Joe? I said, I won three fights in hell. She said, thank God, we'll have some dinner tomorrow. I said, I don't get paid till the competition's over. So she said, well, it's a penny packet of cocoa on a man apiece. Have a spoonful of that and save a spoonful for tomorrow. It was hard days.
They was fighting from the day they were born. Fighting for survival.
To
live. It was a fight to live. And down at the docks, well, there were so many boxers. You know, came from the docks. Dockers, they were part-time boxers and part-time dockers. Not that they wanted to be, but there was no work about it. It was such a struggle. 10 men chasing one job, or more, perhaps 40.
It was hard, hard, doxing days, hard. You used to get a little lead ticket. Put your number on it. Now, every now and then, a checker would come on. A man come on checking the numbers. Now say you went out to go to make water. You're missing. He writes your number on the floor. That means say, go and get paid off. If you was away for one, say when the first hour's work and your number was on there, you was paid off. Nothing. You get one hour's work and out of it. Yeah, it was hard days.
Joe Rolfe had the talent in his fists to escape the insecurity of casual calling on at the docks. He fought as a professional welterweight in the 1920s and 30s. He was never a champion, but a favourite with the crowd.
He was a great fighter. He fought all the best in England. He fought Len Harvey, Elf Mancini, Johnny Brown, the old welterweight champion, Alec Ireland. Elf Mancy, all the best of Jody. But he'd never got, never got what you say to the greats. But he fought them all.
On the floor, sir. Floor, please.
I wouldn't say that Joe made a lot of money. He owned people a lot. He was a great attraction. When he boxed at the ring, the house was packed. He had a great lot of followers, if you know what I mean. Well liked. And he could put up a show. He wouldn't lay down if you... A tough boy, and he could punch with both hands. Oh, a great fighter. If he got some money today, old Joe would have. Yeah. When the family's not earning a lot, they'd box for a pound, wouldn't they? Oh, yes, 1930, that's all they'd get. A pound, might get 25 bob, son. We'll get no more. I went once to the National Sporting Club, with Georgie Ball of Bermondsey. He was a middleweight. He was boxing Jim Carr of Reading. Jim Carr of Reading. Now, this is the Gentleman's Club. 10 rounds. The winner to get £9. And the loser got six. £6. My friend George Ball lost. He got £6. I'll never forget that night. My old mate got a terrible hiding. He was very strong. And I said to him, "Where'd you keep on, boy?" He said, "I wanted an extra £3. Now, how much would them men be worth today? Boxing.
In 1919, I won a competition. I won a six guinea cup. And I shaved down the waterside them days. And I said to the chaps, I said, "When we go down the club tonight, I'll show you my cup." As I tell you, that was angry days. And I got a day's work. And the time when I come home, I expect a bit of bread and cheese, you know, a cup of tea and a bit of bread and cheese. And as I'm walking upstairs, a bit of back room, as I'm walking upstairs, I smell, that smells nice. When I get up there, she's got a big joint of meat, big joint. I said, "Where'd you get your money from? Where'd you buy the money?" She said, "I pawned your cup. I won it on the night time. It was in pawn the next morning."
Well, dear mate, very few families would have survived in Bermondsey without the pawn broker.
That's if you had anything to pawn. They're not in the pawn. One woman used to go round all the houses, all the different, bang on the door, "Well, you got a pawn, see?" And she'd have a pram, or a bassinet, as we call it, pram. Then how much you put down, and she'd come back with a pawn, they'd give her 8p for going. Well, you pawn all the parcels, have all the money, different parcels, as you want. Yeah. That was supposed to be the good, that was the good old days.
People don't realise that the poverty abound, that abounded. If you speak to young men today and to tell them what you had to undergo or what others had to undergo, they'd laugh at you. They'd say, "I wouldn't do it," because they can't realise how bad it was.